Hello. In the previous video, I showed you the effects that this defective USB cable can have. For example, when you use it to power a device like the PortaPack, the PortaPack started to malfunction because of this defective cable. Here we are going to measure this cable using a USB measuring device that can measure voltage and current and then make calculations for resistance and power. A power bank and here an electronic load so that I can draw a constant current. I set it in to draw a constant current here, 250 milliamps, and that is important, that constant current. You can probably see the LED flicker here, but that is an effect of my camera. As I look at it directly, it is not flickering for me. So let's plug this in directly and turn on the load. And here you can see we have about 5 volts and 250 milliamps that is being drawn. And here we measure 5.14 volts at the power bank and 245 milliamps. So what I need to do next here, so we have this measurement, is push this button so that we switch to line measurement, and then we remove the device and put the cable between the device and the power bank so that the cable is being measured like this. And now you can see here quite a difference. We have 5.14 volts without the cable and 4 volts with the cable, and the current drawn is about constant 245. That's the same. So that's a huge difference. We have more than a volt of drop on this cable just with 250 milliamps. So let's push the next button to have the calculation, and then you can see here that this cable has a resistance of 4.693 ohms, and so that's a lot for a USB cable like this. The way this is calculated, so we have a difference of 1 volt, and we are drawing 250 milliamps. 1 volt divided by 0.25 amps, that gives us around 4 ohms. And here it's a bit more. The difference is 1.14, so that explains the 4.693. Let's do the same with a good USB cable. So here I have another USB cable which is electrically fine. Mechanically it is not, there is a bend in it, so this might later on develop into an electrical problem, but for the moment it is fine. So we start this again. So 5.14, 245, push the button, okay, remove the device, put in the cable in between, and now as you can see the voltage drop is way lower, it's from 5.14 to 5.09, so that's a much lower voltage drop, and that is explained by a much lower resistance. So let's make the calculation. And here you can see the resistance is 0.2 ohms. So that's normal for such a small cable like this, while this cable here, it has 4 ohms. I don't have the breakout connectors to measure this directly with a multimeter. I will buy these breakout connectors so that I can do that measurement too. But that is the difference and explains why this cable cannot deliver that much power to a device, because of the resistance causing that voltage drop.